την άποψη ότι οποιαδήποτε νέα έργα στον τομέα της ανακάλυψης φυσικού αερίου και πετρελαίου είναι ασύμβατα με τους στόχους που έχουν τεθεί για μηδενικές εκπομπές ρήπων μέχρι το 2050, εκφράζει σε συνέντευξή του στο alphanews.life ο σύμβουλος του Γενικού Γραμματέα των Ηνωμένων Εθνών για τη βιώσιμη ανάπτυξη, Jeffrey Sachs.
In fact, anything started now would have to be closed down by mid-century. So what's the point? Everybody thinks, well, let me get into just a little bit more. I want to get rich here. We don't need more Mediterranean gas, for example. Think of all the gas in the Middle East at low cost that's already there, but will not be usable safely in the future. So the big issues really are how to make the transformation to zero carbon energy, how to build out a massive solar-based energy system, which is feasible, especially in this region with so much wonderful sunshine, but how to do it in real time, not how to keep developing new oil and gas that is going to have to be shut down.
Ο κύριος Sachs που μας μίλησε στο περιθώριο του Διεθνούς Συνεδρίου για την Κλιματική Αλλαγή που πραγματοποιήθηκε στην Πάφο, περιέγραψε ως σοκαριστικά τα ευρήματα των επιστημόνων για το τι αναμένεται τα επόμενα χρόνια, χαιρέτησε όμως την ετοιμότητα των κυβερνήσεων της περιοχής για κοινή δράση. Πρέπει όμως να γίνουμε πρακτικοί.
So we need technological solutions. We need electric vehicles. We need massive solar energy. But that's not only the sunshine, that's the photovoltaic modules. This region should be producing them. This region should be building a massive grid. Saudi Arabia is making a big investment right now in some of the biggest solar fields in the world. But let's connect Saudi Arabia, the rest of the Middle East, the Eastern Mediterranean, and Europe into one expanded grid.
Οι κλιματικές αλλαγές παράγουν, σύμφωνα με τον Jeffrey Sachs, τρομερές κρίσεις πολιτικής αστάθειας.
We know, by the way, before the explosion of violence in Syria was a massive drought, one of the largest in Syria's modern history. It dislocated lots of people. They couldn't grow food. They came to the cities. People were unhappy, they were tense, there were tensions. These things become the basis of explosions. So it's not a theory for the future, it's what we see in many places in the world right now. It will intensify. We had better be civilized, moral, proper, peaceful, and problem solving. And we're not so good at any of that.